we have a good friend of ours, Wajid Ali Syed, who is currently working with GEO as Washington correspondent and his sister organization, The News. Over the 20 years as an international broadcaster, he helped launch a couple of great projects and has been part of the Daily Times and the Voice of America's flagship Urdu program. He's also writing a series of articles on Pakistan-US relations for TNS. Today we are going to hear from him.
Come on,
Chad. Technical deficiencies for Pakistan and electronic media. Thank you, Wajid, for taking your time.
Yeah, I've been asked to talk about the technical difficulties and everything. I think we have got great panel over here. Aziz and others would talk about what the technical difficulties could be. But I think it's been pretty simple. I don't need to tell you guys, since now you are working in the field and you would understand, you can just hook up a computer or even use your 3G mobile and then you can send out your story. Or even now what I do is that I have my iPhone over here, and if I don't have my camera person nearby, I just shoot footage from here and then send it to you, and that's pretty much it. Within 5 minutes it's on here, and it's on here. So it's technically filed. But what I would like to talk about is my experiences over here dealing with US officials as well as dealing with Pakistani officials who come over here with the same mindset that if they're dealing with Pakistanis or Pakistani officials who have been elected by the Pakistani public, they are in their office, and the way they deal with their offices or with their people, they can treat, or with their press, they can treat the diaspora over here the same way, or the Pakistani and even the American press the same way. I can give you a couple of examples where Nawaz Sharif's Fatmi Saab, the advisor on foreign relations, was here.
Tariq
Fatmi, he was here at the embassy last year, I guess, or the year before, and he was adamant that you have to call a Washington Post chief reporter, I need to see him. It doesn't happen this way. That's one thing, because the way the US media works here is that they will call you. Yes, they will, if you want to be invited, they'll invite you, but then they'll have editors sitting over there, and there's a hierarchy where you won't meet with the publisher or with the editor, you will meet with the concerned department or people who edit those stories or monitor those stories coming in from Pakistan, and then they'll talk to you about serious issues, and you cannot just cover under the table, or you can't just manipulate them. You can just treat the way that they're used to of treating Pakistani press. That's one difference, and same goes for the other delegations who come over. What they do is that they want to talk to American press, but they won't talk to Pakistani press.
Yeah.
Now we are sitting here and we are hoping to reach out to them and to listen to them and to report that what Pakistan or Pakistani delegation has to offer. And we want to promote that. We want to talk about that. We want to say this delegation is here for these meetings. These are the objectives. This is what we want to do. This is what Pakistan wants to. This has been United States' long-standing position, or that concerned department's position, and we are hopeful that if it reaches any conclusion or not. What Pakistani delegations or Pakistani officers who come over here do is that they do not share that information with the Pakistani media, which is very unfortunate, because then we have to go out, we have to work extra hard, which we don't mind, but the thing is then the only story that comes out from the one side, from the American side. If the World Bank says, yes, the delegation is here, and these are the people who will be sitting in that meeting, and these are, and we know that what their point of view have been, we know how strong positioning they are going to have in that meeting, but we don't know what Pakistan wants. We don't know what Pakistan is offering. We don't know how Pakistani delegation or Pakistani officials are going to deal with that situation. So that secrecy makes it very hard for us to reach out to people and for us to write a story that could reach out to public or to the government officials who or the policymakers who are working on that particular project. You know, that's one thing. Then I think what you also need to consider is, and we'll keep it very short, what you also need to consider is the form of government that works here and the form of government that works in Pakistan. USG has a hierarchy. You know, yes, president is the one who calls the shots, but not always, not necessarily. He has got his team, the cabinet members, they can call the shots. Then we've got deputy secretaries and assistant secretaries and the State Department and the Pentagon and Capitol Hill, and the Congress is, depending on who's ruling and how conflicting that is with the White House or not conflicting, the Congress itself is very strong. Congress can, you know, make a law about something that the administration does not want. I can quote another example that when I am reporting for GEO and there is something, for the lack of better word, anti-Pakistan something coming out, a lawmaker presents a law saying we want to do this to Pakistan. Now that does not necessarily mean that that law has been passed, or that that has been implemented, or that the White House or whoever the president is was consulted or agrees with that law or not. But when I report, the way it airs over there is that the United States has done this now, which is very unfortunate. And I figured it out pretty quickly, so I used to call them and ask them that you have to take me live if you want my people. Because I wanted to make sure what I want to say to them or to inform them that this particular piece of law or the paper that has been introduced does not necessarily mean that this has been passed or this is happening or the United States stands against Pakistan doing this or that. It doesn't work like this, and it shouldn't work like this, because even then I experienced, and then they would cut me off in the middle and they would say, thank you very much. But what used to happen was that they would take my beeper and then they'll edit it accordingly and then they'll air it. So that anti-American sentiments that they try to play on with is just very unfortunate. There are young people like you who come over here and you say, why don't you talk to, why don't you interview, or even when I get my, you know, my call from my bosses and say, why don't you talk to, why don't you interview Secretary Clinton, or why don't you interview Secretary or President Bush or President Obama? I mean, again, we can request them, but it depends on their agenda, how they're going to take it. It's not like in Pakistan that you can pick up your phone in the middle of the night and you can say to any minister over there that this is what the other party member has said and what your stance is on that, and then they will give you a reply and then you can run with it. Again, it doesn't work like this over here. So the power circles in Pakistan are quite different. Dealing with them is quite different, and dealing with officials over here or institutions and departments over here is quite different. I think what you guys need to do is, when you are here, you need to figure that out, you need to ask about it, you need to see who stands where and doing what. That would actually help you. I think I should.
I just want to add something. One constant source of a cause of irritation between us and Pakistani officials is national interest. These days, no matter who is the ambassador or who is the embassy official dealing with you, these days when I report that US-Pakistan and US-Pakistan relations have been going down since 2011, and every ambassador, without any exception, said, Anwar Saab, you should not write that. Yes, US-Pakistan relations are bad, but you must say they are good. I said, why? Because it is in national interest. So I said, but how can I say if the relations are bad, if they are going down, how can I say they are good? He said, no, but you must, because it is in national interest. And so much so that it happened to me not once, not twice, at least a dozen times. There are journalists, as in Pakistan, who are very close to the embassy, and I go to a briefing or something, and they just call me, you're the Indian agent. He works for all. I said, but I don't report anything that the India says. I report what American officials say here. I did. Course. You have to protect the national interest.
Wajid, if anybody has any questions. Yeah, you were talking about like it's very hard to reach to Pakistani officials here. So I must, it's just a suggestion, you should something find negative about it. You don't have any idea how they will reach you there. Otherwise they won't, this is not the case here. Now what they have started doing it, specifically officials and the politicians, what they have started doing is in Pakistan as well, they don't talk to reporters. Because they are doing the field work, but they don't talk to them. What they do, they come to their our offices and they go and sit in the bureau chief's office or somebody, the high officials, so that, you know, the officials could tell us, like, you don't supposed to do this for them and you don't supposed to do this for him or her, whatever that is. So what you need to do is, you need to, if you want to reach them, you need to find out some negative aspects from their stories. And then they will reach you, they will contact you by yourself.
That's a great situation, but I think I grew out of that 15, 16 years ago when I started working here. So I've learned a lot over the years. Yeah. Also, that when you are reporting, whatever you're reporting about the subject or the meeting, and you're, because you have access to just one party, and you're still trying to balance it out, then automatically for some reason goes against the Pakistani party. Because one, they didn't give you the access, they didn't tell you what they are going to do, but as Anwar Sahab has just mentioned, that when you're going to finally publish that story, they're going to take it negative. They're going to say they would rather not have that story published than, you know, give us the information. So not necessarily, you know, works always, because for them it's already very negative, because, you know, again, they didn't give us the information.
I don't think so, babe. You should be complaining because you belong to Jio, and Jio is
we already got that distinction. Yes.
When we are living in Pakistan and Jio is the number one in rating kind of thing, सबसे पहले तो ऐसे समा की होती है, लेकिन Jio भी कोशिश करता है, समा बारी ले जाता है, बाजी ले जाता है, समा बाजी ले जाता है. But when we are talking to the international issues, it is always like, you being here, the correspondent, you have the access to Trump and Bush, and demand is like, take the people, and if officials are, how you deal with that pressure, and how is it to get that person for the people?
Frankly, the system over here, in my experience, and because Hannah is sitting there, so I don't want to like go off my lane, but the system what I've experienced over here is that they've got a pretty organized structure. So if you access the State Department, there are a couple of people that either you know personally or otherwise officially, and then you can write to them, and whatever they are saying, they will let you know. And even if they don't want to say anything, they will let you know about that as well. But I thought about these elections, maybe I just want to talk about it. What you also have to do over here is, you know, President ko, ya White House ko, ya Trump ko, ya secretary hain, unko to access nahi kar sakta, but my access is unke office tak hai. So I wrote to the State Department today, and whatever the response they gave me, there is a very clear distinction that you have to notice, and you have to know what that means. Because there is the State Department spokesperson, and then there's a State Department spokesperson. There's a hell of a difference between these two. So you have to, like, you know, keep that balance and know about what you're doing. And another thing what I lately started doing was that I started a series on Pakistan United States relationship. And I'm covering different aspects of it. It gets published in the news on Sunday magazine twice a month, sometimes once a month. But that's my way of dealing with my crisis, that I need to say something in 1,000 and 1,500 words that I cannot say in 30-second people, you know. So I can detail it out what it means, you know. That wo Islamabad mein unfortunate incident, the military attaché got into this accident and unfortunately killed these two guys, is not linked to jo yahan par travel restrictions lag rahi thi in Pakistani. Which is totally different, you know, because there are things that are already in works, you know, things that are already happening in the background. It's just so happened to you that that mishap took place. But otherwise, same goes with when Kerry Lugar bill came out. I mean, you know, we know
We know who was working on that. Usse pehle Bush administration had already started on that. Vice President Joe Biden was actually going to introduce that, because, but because he was running and because he became the Vice President, it was given to other his colleagues. So, and how healthy and good it was for Pakistan. And the way Pakistan reacted to that was just astonishing. That Secretary of State sitting in Lahore said that, listen, this is our money. If you want to take it, take it. If you don't want to take it, we don't want to give you that. You know, if you're not happy with it. So understanding just in that public sentiment jo create kiya jata hai, usme where do we stand and where are these news stories coming from and what are they actually projecting, what are they actually telling you? I think that's also the difference that we need to understand in this process.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have